Hello everyone and warm welcome to this session. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you the implementation of Gaussian high pass filtering on a grayscale image. So let us switch to the editor window. I maximize it. So as Gaussian high pass filtering is one of the frequency domain image enhancement methodology, we need to generate the filter mask and the image information to be read in the MATLAB environment and work into the frequency domain for applying the filter operation. So let us start coding with the MATLAB syntaxes of close all, clear, clc, so that we can have fresh execution of our program. First line is a comment to mention the motive behind writing this particular program. So this is a program to demonstrate the Gaussian high pass filter. So first of all, we need to read the image so that we can process it accordingly. So the first module is read the input image from the current folder. So I will generate the variable capital A with the help of imread command followed by a pair of parentheses, where inside a pair of single quotes I provide a string that it is the name of the image to be accessed along with its file type. Very popular image dataset, cameraman.tif, I am going to access here. Let us save the script with the name, for example, program_18.m will be the file extension. As I get back to the default view of MATLAB, you see the file is generated here. In the current folder, the name has appeared to the editor tab. The workspace is now empty. If I run this particular program, it is successfully generating the variable A with the requisite dimension as it has for the cameraman.tif. Now we can continue the programming in the editor window. So after successfully reading the image, let us make the use of two variables that hold the dimensions of the input image. Not necessary that always it will be a square image plane. For cameraman.tif, both the values are 256 pixels on row wise or column wise you go. So assignment of the dimensions of the input image is possible to the two variables with the help of MATLAB syntax size, where the input argument I provide capital A, which has holded up that information here. Now let us set the cutoff frequency of the high pass filter of Gaussian type here. So I just write set the cutoff frequency. So for cutoff frequency, I will generate the variable fc that will be assigned with the value 10 here. Initially I can change it later on. And now let us have detecting the center of the image plane. So I just write determine the center of image plane here. So for that purpose, I will require two more variables to be generated. I will go with half of the image dimensions and round it further. So m divided by 2, and then we will have rounding of the second dimension divided by 2 here. So P and Q I have generated, and this will get me to the center of the image plane where I can apply the filter mask so that it will overlap the entire image plane here. So now after determining the center of the image plane here, let us generate the filter mask or filter kernel of the Gaussian type for high pass filter here. So I just write and define the filter mask or filter kernel here. So let us represent it with the help of variable capital H. So initially I assign it a matrix of zeros with the same dimensions as that of the input image, so m and n here. I will have formulation of H possible with the help of the nested for loop. The first for loop I will construct with the variable I, that will iterate from 1 to small m, inside which I construct another for loop that will iterate for j is equal to 1 to small n. Here I will define a variable small d computed as I minus p to its power. We will have the value 2. This is further added by j minus q, which is also having a power 2 here. So I will end this syntax with the help of semicolon. I will have now the use of the variable d to formulate the filter function denoted by h of I comma j. So for Gaussian type of high pass filter, we need to make the use of exponential function. So exp of minus d by 2 I will do, and divided by, this is fc, again fc will be there, square of it. So I will end the nested for loop here, and as this will give you the low pass filtering here, the h we can obtain for high pass filtering by subtracting it from 1 here. So h is equal to 1 minus h we can do, so that we can have the filter mask for the Gaussian type high pass filtering here. So now it's time to get the image information into the frequency domain representation, whereupon we can operate the filter onto it. So I will write input image in frequency domain. So I will generate the variable a underscore f with the help of FFT shift and the Fourier direct transformation onto the two-dimensional signal. The syntax is FFT2 will be operated on the original image that we have stored onto the variable a here. By the next line, we have to now apply the filter mask. So this is of the Gaussian high pass type here. So now let us have generation of the variable b that will hold that filtered image represented in the frequency domain. So as we know, the convolution into the spatial domain or time domain here, as we are working with the two-dimensional signal, the image plane representation is there in spatial domain. So convolution operation is nothing but the multiplication in the frequency domain. So we will have a underscore f, the frequency domain information of image, element wise multiplied to the filter mask generated here. So for element wise multiplication, we have dot asterisk here, and finally representing the filtered image back to the spatial domain, we will have the absolute of the inverse Fourier transform applied. So inverse Fourier transformation syntax is IFFT2 here. This will be applied onto the variable capital B. So lastly, we will display the results here along with the input image that was processed. So display the input and output image. So I will make the use of subplot here. I will generate two rows, two columns. In the first cell, I will have the visualization of the original image that was stored into the variable A. The concerned title here I provide, so that it is original image. By the next line, I go for the next cell of subplot, that it is 2, 2, 2. Thereupon, I will like to have the display of the filter function in two dimensions. So for that case, we will make the use of imshow command. The concerned title, it will be 2D view of the filter function denoted by h here. By the next line, I go for the subplot 2, 2, 3. I will write the use of surf command to show you the 3D visualization of the filter function. So this is 3D view of the filter function denoted by h. So this should be a string type here. so it should be provided in a pair of single quotes. And the last line here, it goes with the subplot 2,2,4, where I'm going to have a display of the resultant image after Gaussian type of the high pass filtering. That information is stored in the variable C, so it will be of the double type. We need to get it back in the uint8 for visualization with the help of imshow command, otherwise it will be a complete white or a complete black screen. So the concern title, finally I provide, this is image after Gaussian high pass filter. So this is what a complete MATLAB program. I save this particular script completely and run this particular program. So now you see, along with the variable A that has holded the image information read in MATLAB with the help of this particular syntax here, we have image information in frequency domain, the operation of filter mask onto the image information in frequency domain, and finally by the use of inverse Fourier transform, we get the resultant image stored into the variable C. This is the filter function we have generated for Gaussian high pass filtering type here with the help of the exponential function, and rest of the variables we have generated while having the implementation of formulation here. So this is what the subplot we have for the cameraman.tif processed by the filter functions. So high pass filter type, you see the set cutoff frequency was equal to 10 here, and this is what the result here. Now if I change the cutoff frequency, let us say the value will be 40 this time, saving changes, running the program again, you see the corresponding change into the visualization of the output image here as I expand the span for the cutoff frequency for high pass here. So this space will be discarded into the output here. So this is what a broad opening in the 3D view of the filter function. The same can be visualized also in two-dimensional view. So this I have demonstrated for the cameraman.tif. If I change the input image, instead of having the cameraman.tif, if I make the use of horse.jpg, the image data set available with us. So let us see what is the resultant image. So you see, after processing the original image horse.jpg through the high pass filter, we get this corresponding output. As compared to this original image, the filter function is quite much broader here. If I lower down the value, let us say for example to 15, saving the changes, running it, so here we obtain the resultant image of horse.jpg processed after the Gaussian type, the Gaussian, the bell shape you see here for the high pass filtering. So this has operated onto the original image and generated this kind of the result here. So this was a simple demonstration of how we implement the Gaussian type of high pass filtering, one of the frequency domain image enhancement methodology, to operate on the grayscale image as we have shown with cameraman.tif or horse.jpg. We can also go it with other image data sets available in the current folder. Thank you.